Hello, welcome to AILTV. My name is Temitope Olodo. I'm here to talk to you about a very, very important subject, radicalization within our community. This is a subject close to my heart. As you know, we have spoken about it on this platform before. In fact, before many experts did, we spoke about it here on AILTV. So call your family, call your friends, get your cup of coffee, sit down, let's talk about it. Why are we having this challenges within our community where youths are going on, you know, to be radicalized and actually exhibiting violent extremism? What are the drivers, you know, that is making this something that is happening continuously and our government, you know, people in authority have not been able to nip it in the bud? Now, remember, after July 7th, sad incident, you know, led to death of many people. An office called the Office for Security and Counterterrorism was set up. And that office then had to work with what is called the context strategy. And that context strategy has a 4 P's to it. So there is prepare, there is prevent, there is protect, you know, and there's prepare. And you know, I had the privilege of working under the prevent aspect of that project, where you deal with the issue of de-radicalization, which is more or less deconstructing youth that are, you know, dragged or attracted to violence extremism. Now let's look at what is happening now. We have close to 700 youths, you know, British that have actually gone to Syria to become foreign fighters there, and about 200 of them have returned back home, you know, carrying that violence extremism ideology back into the UK. And we're having concerns that are these kids going to turn back and become homegrown terrorists, you know, and actually attack us? Those are the kind of concerns that is happening. And with what happened in Paris and what happened in America, a lot of people are really, really bothered that, you know, is London going to be next? Of course, few days afterwards in Leytonstone, just around the corner from us here, you know, an incident happened where an individual stood up, you know, started stabbing people, you know, and thank God that those people, you know, so far we know that none of them have died. But now, after 7/7, the Prime Minister have come out to say that at least 7 attempts, you know, have been foiled, you know, of, you know, incidents of terrorist incident have been void, you know, in the United Kingdom. Now, what we don't know is where those individuals have come from. But what we're very sure of is that the Woolwich incident was committed by a British Nigerian, so people of Nigerian origin. And the latest incident in Leytonstone was committed by somebody with an Somalian heritage. Now, these are two big communities within the United Kingdom, you know, of ethnic minority. And yet we've not seen, you know, after the 7/7 bombing, which was committed by people of Asian heritage. So we are now moving into, is the next one going to be people of Arabic, you know, heritage? Because those group, we've not seen anything from them yet. So those are the kind of issues that we need to be looking at, because we are getting to a point where we need to make sure that our youth are de-radicalized, you know, and identified very quickly. And when you identify that your child is going through a sort of violence extremism process, you need to be able to speak to the appropriate authority to get help. You know, there is a program called Channel, which, you know, through either your children's school or through the local authority, you could actually get your child if they have concerns. My organization, Nigerian Diaspora Security Forum, we help, you know, youths who are of Nigerian origin that might actually have concerns, or parents that might have concerns about their kids going down the route of violence extremism. But we're not restricted, you know, to just Nigerians alone. If you belong to the West African or African, you know, kind of origin or from that route and you have concerns, just get in touch with me, Google my name, Temitope Olodo, and get in touch with me, and I'll be more than happy to help you, because there are different drivers to terrorism, and it's about understanding those drivers. Some people is due to the environment where they are, you know, they say poverty, but, you know, people in Africa, you know, don't even get a 3 square meal, but yet they're not all turning to become terrorists. So that could be dismissed very quickly. And there is the issue of foreign affairs and the issue of what is happening in Syria, which people are raising. But let's deal with those things one after the other. But get in touch with us and we will help you. Welcome to AILTV.